powered by Virginia Radio.
Coming to the West Indies. Coming to the West Indies. Coming to the West Indies 2022. We out here, man. And we got Rick Rogers out here with us, man.
My boy got the podcast outside with him, though.
Yeah, we don't play, man. We take this wherever we go, man. We set it up anywhere and everywhere, man. We streaming basketball games. We streaming pep rallies. We streaming podcasts, promos, man. Everything, man. Man, what's up? What's up with you, though, Rick, man? What's up with you, Rick?
I'm just chilling, bro. Just living my life, trying to, you know, maintain best as I can, for real, for real.
Okay.
Working on a new album, about to come out in probably like a month or two.
Word. What's the name of this one?
Rick Miyagi Part 4.
We have the Part 4.
I actually recently had like an, you know, encounter with Christ or whatever, so it kind of makes sense to call it Rick Miyagi 4 Christ, so that's the name of the album, for real, for real.
Ricky Miyagi 4 Christ. Wow.
Right.
For Christ this time. That's right. That's dope, man. It came around like that. Just like that.
Happened to be on number 4. That's crazy though.
That's how it happens, right?
Right.
For real, man. So, come on, man. Tell the people right quick, man. You gotta let it out, man. You came into the encounter with Christ. How did that happen?
It was honestly like, all right, my whole life I always had a heart for people. But I never really know what to say to people to actually pull them out of whatever darkness that they dealing with, you know what I'm saying? So being that I'm an engineer and everything, I travel with artists, you know what I mean? So I record secular raps and I record Christian artists too. So one of the things that stuck out to me is like, I noticed whenever we out of town with like secular artists, it's always a necessity for guns, drugs,
come on,
and women.
Come on.
Right?
Come on.
And when I started traveling with Christian artists, I never seen so many people smiling in my life, because you know where we come from, you know what I'm saying? And the vibes was just so much better, everybody happy, and I just always was wondering what it was. I always knew about God, but I never really opened the Bible and read it.
True.
And when I finally decided to open it and read it, I never found more sound device for the issues that I'm having directly in my life. It's almost like the Bible was reading me, you know what I'm saying?
Facts.
And just from there, I just started doing my research, like trying to figure out, am I tripping? Like, is this feeling crazy? And I can't find nothing to make me feel different about how I feel right now. And I just really want to share the love, because that's what the gospel is. It's about love, for real. Like,
definitely.
It's not about the self-love. It's about loving other people, bro. Love is what you do in spite of how you feel, my nigga.
Loud facts, man. Love is love, man. And the positivity, man, changes everything, man. You know, the energy, man, is real, you know? And when you're moving with something, it doesn't matter what it is, but it has a positive energy. It doesn't matter if it's God, Christ, Allah, Buddha, whatever it be. It be that positive energy that's around that circle. And when it's not that energy inside, something really tears that apart somehow, you know? And when you're moving with the other energy, with the guns, the drugs, the women, all the negativity, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It just...
It's not
a different
good.
Energy, man.
It's not good. It's
too many of our rappers are losing their lives over it, man.
And you know, one of the main things that really, really, really made me make my decision is the gospel, they call it the word. When you think about words, words is the only way we learn anything.
Yes.
Experience, yeah, but even as you experience, you talking, you reading, everything is about words, so... I started really paying attention to the words that was coming out of my mouth, you know what I'm saying? Because what you listen to is what you become at the end of the day, in some sense, you know what I'm saying? Like, so what it was for me, for real, my son had to perform at a high school all-star game.
Mm-hmm.
And they was playing like the Cardi B's, the Wap It, da, 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 like, oh, right, I don't knock the music,
right,
I don't knock it, but
come on,
what
come
I'm
on.
Looking at is kids from the ages 4 to 16
That's
singing
growing up on.
This music and becoming what they
become,
hearing.
Exactly.
And I just made a personal decision.
It's so
like,
powerful, bro. The word, the music, the energy is so powerful, man.
And we don't really pay attention to it, for real.
Nah.
Like, that stuff be downloading in these kids' brains, bro.
Yo, I'm on my son 24-7 with it. 24-7 to the point where he gets mad at me. Because I'm putting him on, because he ain't understanding, you know what I'm saying? And I'm breaking it down, and everything, know what's happening? This is what God doing, right? God keep confirming it for him.
That's how, bro, like, that was, like, that's how it was to me, bro. You know how many times I doubted him, bro? I mean, even after my encounter, bro, I just kept questioning, like, man, I feel like I was tripping, like, because my whole life I ran away from it, bro. But it's like, once you run into what you feel like is the truth, bro, you just got to go
once
with
you
what
know,
you
know,
bro.
Exactly. Yeah. And after you know, it ain't no turning back on what you know, man. Especially
actually,
if you know,
what I did with the project this time is, just from the Christian artists that I have listened to, it's always this false sense of, like, total happiness. It's like, nah, like, that's not really all it is. So, just like I've been doing in my recent music, I talk about my life that day and how I feel about whatever it is. So, I tried to make an album that people from the secular world can listen to. Because I feel like everybody has that question, like, is God real? Do he love me and all that? So, I actually tried to make an album that can relate to both sides of the field, for real.
Quick question. When a person comes to you and asks you, is God real, how do you break it down in your form of letting them know or introducing them to the God that you know? How do you break it down for them?
I mean, bro, for me, honestly, bro, and this is a moment in my life where I actually cried thinking about it. It's like, because I thought I was my own God. I got into all that, bro, like thinking this stuff, and then it's like, it's no way. For one, when we think about ourselves as humans, we don't even give our creator the credit. Like, we make babies, you feel me, and processes that we can't even understand. Like, I have 5 children, bro. They started as babies, bro. Like, they came from sperm, bro. That is the best technology, like, ever, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like, that's one of them, you know what I'm saying? But we go crazy over the iPhone. We go crazy over the newest car, but we don't go crazy over the person who gave us all of it, bro. You know what I'm saying? And my thing was, over my life, I was like, ain't nobody walk on water. Ain't nobody come back from the dead. Ain't nobody do this. But when you step outside and you realize that it's a real moon sitting up in the sky, or it's a sun that comes around, like, it's what other miracles do you need, bro? You feel me? We don't cherish what it is, bro. If you think about it, bro, trees give us the air we need to breathe. If I choked you out, you're going to die without the air. So my thing was, that's what helped me realize I'm not my own God, because I can't supply myself with life. You know what I'm saying? And it's a humble experience to me. I get what people say, because it's a form of trying to make you believe in yourself in a higher way. I understand that, but you have to give it the right way. Like, if we suffocate each other, we gonna die. So the credit gotta go somewhere else.
True indeed, man. That's dope, man. The credit does have to go to the Most High, man. When my son asked me, you know, and I'm not a person that ever read the Bible. I'm not a person that, you know, been really into any religions, you know.
Right.
I'm a person that, you know, live life thinking I knew everything, and I learned everything, like Locke say, living off experience, you know.
Mm-hmm.
And I experienced that, you know, it's a big energy thing going on, and it's like, you can work for the God, to me, which is like the Most Highest power of positive energy, or you can work for, you know, like the devil, which is the most lowest power, which will equal the negative energy. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And I taught my son, like, when people teach you God, like, I can't teach you about no person. You know what I'm saying? I never met that person.
Right.
But I understand that energy.
Right.
You know what I mean? I understand that, you know, God mentality. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
Like, understand if it was a person, right, they had to have moved a different way. How can they have been so great?
Right.
How can they have been able to create all this? Because, you know, even if you are a good, but if you keep doing wrong, what happens? You know what I mean? If you keep doing wrong, even if you get away with a head, man, that's how people do, you know what I'm saying? And next thing you know, it comes back bigger and bigger and more, and you got to live with everything you do. It's like, yo, man, I'm going to teach you about energy. And I believe that, you know, that's like the Most Highest power, which is God. And that's how I had to break it down.
In a sense, right,
you know what I mean?
And I realized that, too, with just looking up, because, like I said, bro, and I thought I was tripping about what I was feeling like, because it's real tears, bro. It really, for me, it was real tears. It was really staring outside looking ungrateful. But one morning I was recording a song, you know, for the album and jump, and I just so happened to look at my window. I'm like, yo, that is crazy. It would be a fire painting, but it's not a painting. Like, someone really put this here, you know what I'm saying? So I just began to start actually having gratitude. Like, and it's like, one of the realest conversations I had with somebody, he made me realize something, because my whole life I've been trying to figure out how to love myself, you know what I'm saying? Which is something I don't knock But when you think about creation, nothing was created to serve itself. You know what I'm saying? Like, the sun don't shine on itself. You know what I mean? The trees don't help other trees breathe. Everything helps something else. So as humans, I understand now. And what I learned from reading just about Jesus himself, whether people believe is real or not, like, what I tell people to do is, if you want, take the entities out and just look at the story and what it actually mean. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's like somebody coming out here saying, yo, I'm gonna kill everybody out here, and then one of us standing up saying, nah, you know what, take me. You know what I'm saying? That's loving other people. Everyone out here be like, nah, take him. I got kids. Like, it's not about yourself, you know what I'm saying? And what I realized for real is, like, love is what you show other people, bro. You know what I'm saying? And some, you're gonna get hurt and all of that is cool, but what matters is that you love people, and you don't want to be a hypocrite because you want love too. You know what I'm saying? You can't go out here not showing it when you want it. That just makes you a hypocrite off back.
Yes, definitely.
And that's something that hit me real strong, bro. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely.
And I just want to be a change. Like, you know, I feel like even with this walk I'm taking with the music and everything, I feel like I'm being an eyeball, but I would rather do that if I could save somebody from crying every night, because I'm a person that really be doing that. Like, I wake up not knowing whether I want to live. Like, it's real. I don't know what people think, you know what I'm saying, mm-hmm. but I'm a real person. And what I know about everybody, because I done talked to killers, murderers, we all crying, bro, mm-hmm. on the inside, but we don't realize we're doing it to ourselves. So I'm really trying to bring some light to that,
bro. You are doing it to yourself, no matter who you are, man. You are doing it to yourself, man. And it is something that's bigger than all of us, but it's also us. We got to stop doing it to ourselves. I was doing it to me for 35 years, so I know what it is. You know what I mean? And I had to switch it up, man, because, like you said, man, we got kids. And maybe I didn't know what I knew when I was a kid. You know what I mean? Because if I knew what I knew now, you know what I mean, I definitely wouldn't be trying to show my son a different way.
One of the beautiful things I actually learned about God is, like, you have to let someone experience darkness so you know what the light really is. That's where the testimony come into play. Wow. You know what I'm saying? Like, because if it was just all light for me all day, I couldn't even relate to nobody who be crying in their car. Like, some people can't relate to it, but it's people that really need to be pulled out of darkness, bro. And I would rather do that with my life than to try to go with the crowd. And just,
definitely.
You know what I'm saying?
Definitely, man. I'm proud of you, man, because, you know, most people, they not with that. And it mainly is about the money. You know what I mean? Everybody want the bag. They want the bag. That's what everybody say, you know? But if you really want the bag, man, just do what you love, man. And never go against that. Just do what you love, what you really love, man. And push it. Like, what you love, what you talking about, what you want to do, man, go full force with it. You know what I'm saying? Don't play with it. You know what I mean? Put all your energy into it. You know, and it's going to take you. Like me, man, I put all my energy into what I want. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And it's taking me there. You know what I'm saying? It's taking me everywhere. And I'm like, wow, man. You know what I'm saying? I'm just sitting back, just like in the matrix at this point. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm just going to continue to do the right thing. You know what I'm
saying?
It's
just a big deception, bro. Especially in our community, bro. We've been deceived, bro. And it's like, it's instilled in so many generations after generation after generation, bro. And I just want to be the one from mine that said, like, that's not it.
Yeah,
you know what I'm saying?
Definitely,
if I could save one person, bro, from them suicidal thoughts, that's all I want to do, bro.
Yeah. You know, a lot of the music that's coming out, you know, is like that. I feel like my son listens to a lot of suicidal music. You know what I'm saying? And I talk to him about these songs, and I'm like, well, if you're not really, like, you know what I'm saying, wanting to do drugs or wanting to kill yourself or wanting, why is this all you pumping in your? And he's like, because of the vibe. And I'm like, the vibe is what's gonna get you the same thing as getting them. Like,
see, I don't even knock it though, because I've made music like that. You know what I'm saying? But like the biggest thing I'm trying to change in my life right now is, because, like, after I start reading the Bible, bro, I always thought I was a good person. Uh-huh. Because I don't rob, kill, steal, you know what I'm saying? But
what
a lie
doing?
Is, I lie, you know what I'm saying? I fornicate, you know what I mean? It's all type of things it's more things to being a bad person than just robbing, killing, and stealing, bro. So it's just all about the accountability, for real.
Yep.
And just taking responsibility for what we doing. Like, it's no way, it's no way. People, especially people who make music antagonizing killers, or we done killed your man, we up on the scores, like, you killing more of your people when you do that. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, we need to understand that, bro. It's not okay.
Yeah, it's not.
And
definitely
we make
not.
It okay, bro. We make it okay for these little girls about here twerking half naked. It's not okay, because that's going to lead them to destruction, bro.
Now facts.
And it's been doing it time and time and time and time again. I don't see how nobody, well, I can't say
it's
that because
early
I've
and
been
early
there.
And early
I've
now.
Been there. You
Think
know what I'm saying?
It.
I've been there in that path. And And I never want nobody to think I'm perfect. I still feel how I feel about a lot of stuff. I still be on the edge. Like, sometimes I even be mad at guys. Like, yo, you really want me to not be mad at this person that just carried me? You know what I'm saying? But it's like, you just have to, you just can't be a hypocrite with nothing that you do. Once you become a hypocrite, you become part of the problem.
For real.
At the end of the day, no matter what it is that you do, whether you lying to your girl, cheating on your girl, hurting her, talking down to her, whatever, like, you can't get mad at her for doing it to you when you doing it too. So both of y'all got to come to the realization that y'all doing this to y'all, to yourself and to each other.
Loud facts. Everything you do is doing this to you. Even if you trying to, your tendency to like try to play somebody.
Yeah, bro.
Playing yourself, man.
That don't crazy,
you'll
bro.
Kill somebody, you killing yourself,
so
man. You gotta live with that forever.
I feel like black people in general is special, bro. But we never gonna get to see it because we so deceived by what we thinking. Like,
yeah,
never's, you know,
a powerful
saying?
Word, man. We just gotta keep pushing, man. We gotta keep pushing, man. And this jump for numbers, man. Look at all the numbers out here today, man. Look what y'all did today, man. Brought together this beautiful community, man. Doing a beautiful thing in the community. The coming to the West Indies Festival.
You know what's crazy?
22.
After this,
yes.
Half of us gonna go home and cry.
Come on, come on.
By ourselves in our room in the dark because we can't figure out why we feel like this.
Come on, man. Come on. We can't be doing that, man.
You
we
get gotta, what I'm saying?
Yeah, we got to stop. We got to stop, man. Listen, man, I'm going to tell you like this, man. I was there before, you know. I was there where I was in the room crying. You know what I'm saying? And at the end of the day, right, I'm not going back to the room crying about none of that. You know what I'm saying? So it's painful. Yeah. But how long you want that pain to eat you up?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Pain kills, you know what I mean? And I don't want it to kill anybody no longer than it has to. So please, if you out there and you know you is gonna go home and cry, man, don't cry for too long. You feel me?
Nah, you gotta get it out, though.
Get it out, man. Definitely. Get it out, man.
It be healthy a little bit sometimes.
Hey, bro, it's all energy, man. I'm gonna keep preaching this, man, to anybody I come across, man. If we can control our energy, right? Even if we are sad, let's say we cry, let's say anything can happen, right? And it makes us sad, you know what I mean? Like me, it doesn't matter if I'm sad or excited. I'm not going to give it too much of my energy.
Right.
So even if I'm excited, yeah, it's done. Back to work.
See, with me,
even if
like
I'm
that.
Sad, I'm hurt.
Bro,
but yo, I got to get back to work. You know what
for
I'm saying?
For me, bro, it was like, it'd be 3 hours at a time.
Facts.
Not no more because I know better now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? For one, it's unproductive.
Yeah.
Especially when you're doing stuff that like we doing. Like, you don't want to be unproductive at all.
You
know what I'm saying?
You can't. There's no way.
Yep.
You know what I mean? It tears up your business. You know what I'm saying?
And I understand now, too. For a while, I used to be mad at people.
Yeah.
But I understand, like, we don't know. It's like you said, you have the spirit of God, you got the spirit of the devil.
Come on.
It's the spirit that's controlling everybody, making them do it, so you can't really be mad at the person.
Come on.
You got to be fight the evil, and you fight the evil by telling the truth.
Always. I teach my son right there, man. That's the quickest way, man. The quickest way is to, you know, just be 100, you know what I'm saying? And when you got to lie, you know what I'm saying? All you're doing is you lying to yourself. You're hurting yourself. You know what I'm
saying?
Calling it confusion. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? We can't lie. We can't make excuses. We can't, we just got to make it happen, man. You know what I'm saying? And the greatest thing is that no matter what we're trying to make happen, we can make happen. No matter who you are, no matter what you want to do, you can do it for real.
Yep.
If I can be out here with a radio station, if I can be booked this month alone, you know, 10 times, you know, anybody can do this. You know what I'm saying? It doesn't matter what you choose to do.
Right.
Just go out there and make sure, son, that you, see, don't lie. Make sure, son, that you really want to do.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because that's what happens. You know, a lot of people lying and they go out there and do it for a little while, you know what I mean? And then they ain't doing it no more. You know what I'm saying? So if it's something that you really love, you can make it happen because that's how it works. It works in us people. Like, I ain't never been to school or none of that, man. It works for me by just going out there doing what I love.
Right.
I'm a promoter.
You,
I love
you
the
be
push.
Grinding for real,
you
too.
Know what I'm saying? I love to promote a nice shirt, a nice CD, you know, somebody else's business. You know
right.
what I'm saying? I just like to promote, bro. You feel me? So I'm going with it 100%. I'm putting my all into it. I'm riding with God with that one. You feel
right.
me? I'm like, yo, God, I'm going to work for you. I'm going to go out here and promote positive energy. You feel me? That's my deal. You know what I'm saying? It's the deal I made with God. And that's all I do.
Right. I've never felt a negative vibe from you ever.
I can't change that. Like, I can't go back on that. None of that. I have to, at the same time, make sure I'm aware of my surroundings at all times, man. But I'm going to push positive energy 24/7 no matter what. I feel better doing this than I ever was 35 years in the streets of struggling or not knowing how I was going through this or that, or, you know, because living like that, anything can happen. Man, at any given moment, you know what I'm saying?
Everything.
Yeah. So Now the circle is a lot stronger. The energy is a lot stronger. The connections are coming. Like, everything I've been thinking about or wanting to do, like, it's been starting to happen, man.
I remember talking to you about before you said you had an idea of what you was going to do.
Yeah.
So I just get to sit back and watch you do it, bro. That's the craziest thing to me, bro.
Yeah. It's like all just making a deal with God, like, but fulfilling my part. You're not ever slacking on my behalf, you know, because right. God ain't never slacking. God on his job. God doing everything he did. He gave us the opportunity to be here, G. It's up to us now what we gonna do. Like, why we gonna keep blaming God or keep talking about God? Like, listen, let God know that everybody know this is through God. Teach them how to utilize God. Teach them how to utilize, control their energy. You know what I'm saying? Because as long as you can control your energy, man, you ain't going to be stooping to nobody's level.
That's the craziest misconception about when you think about forgiveness, bro.
Uh-huh.
People think forgiveness is about letting somebody off the hook. It has nothing to do with the other person, bro. It's about you.
Yeah.
You feel me? People are still crushed from things that happened 15 years ago.
Yeah.
And when it comes back in your mind, it slows you down from whatever it is that you're doing. So forgiveness is actually for you to be able to live your life in a more happy way,
yeah.
bro.
And to let it go.
Yeah.
Whatever it is bothering you, let it go. Move on and start working on you. Because the most important to this thing is you. But you can't make it happen for nobody else. If you love everybody else, you want to help everybody else. Without you can't do it.
Right.
So you got to be straight
right.
so you can do all that.
Right.
If you ain't straight, how you gonna continue to do that? So a lot of people don't like to give they self or know that it's them, because we've been told everything else. But without us too, man, without us controlling this mind that we have the opportunity to control.
Yeah.
You got the opportunity to say, yo, I want to do this or I don't. And once you gain control over, we need some more self-control out here. We need to have more self-control awareness that we are in control of this.
And one thing I want everybody who listens to this zone to understand, and I'm going to curse because I'm not perfect. I be trying, mm-hmm. I curse a lot, you know what I'm saying? But I have to let everybody know this, like, what you think is a bag of shit is really a bag of gold
mm-hmm.
once you start telling the truth.
Like, facts.
All this pain that I have in my heart and everything, like all this anger I have, when I begin telling the truth about it on the music, I become a hero for millions of people that's scared to do it. They don't want to tell the truth because society don't want you to. Society want to lie to it. Whenever people start telling the truth, they start making you feel bad about it, bro. But when you start speaking your truth and you stand up for the right things, bro, you actually become a hero for people, bro. So you can turn your bag of shit to a bag of gold once you start living in your truth, bro.
That's right.
That's a fact, bro. When you look at these people and they give a testimony, these rappers that came from all these broken homes and mm-hmm. then you become successful, bro, that's like shit to gold.
Yeah, definitely is, man. Definitely is, man.
For real, it's
crazy, man. And that's how I feel my life was, man. Shit to go. Because, you know, I come from doing a whole bunch of BS. And now I ain't doing none of that no more. And like, everything is, like you said, shit to go. I'm not even going through the same problems.
You're the definition of what God's glory is. People don't understand what the glory is. The glory is the coming out of what it was.
Come on.
Into something better. That's when he get his glory. When we decide to turn our life around and do what's right. That is the glory.
Definitely. That's all the glory.
I believe you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. All day, every day, man. Man, that's our message to all the people out there, man. All the people out there, man, to do the right thing, man. Like Spike Lee said a long time ago, man. And you know that's not to lie. You know what I'm saying? I don't care what you in. But let's think about that, right? Let's take it back, man. Let's take it back. Because think about this, man. Let's say you are a person, right? And you get pulled over, right? And you're not supposed to be armed. And you're armed. And you have to lie to the police. Because they ask you, are you armed? And you say, no. You know what I mean?
Of course.
I'm just saying, though.
Yeah.
But for real, though, you know what I'm saying? But we got to think about this, because then we become the hypocrites, right?
Right.
So, like, how do we go about that?
Bro, lies live longer than people. When you think about a lie, bro, you have to live it for 15 years until the truth come out. I got
no problem living with that lie, you said? Like, I got no problem with that lie.
You think it's not a problem.
Yeah.
You think it's not. When I first had my encounter, bro,
uh-huh.
I had fucked up some money one time with the rent, you know what I'm saying? My wife asked me what happened. I told her a lie. I felt so bad. It's like, how can I be her husband and send her out here in this world? And I just lied to her about, you know what I mean? Like, I had to complain to her, because once you think about a lie, bro, you have to live your everyday life defending that lie, which now means you're not even living out what your destiny really was now. Because you have to fake everything now, because you're lying about everything.
Right.
Whether it's your career, like, I see a lot of rappers, they lie about where you actually at with your career. Like, it's hard to make the correct move when you have to make everything up based off of the lies that you told. You know what I'm saying? Definitely. So, like, it's no point of lying. It's hard to do. It's hard to tell the truth.
I'm going to be honest with you, man. If I lie to you, it's to save my life, make sure that I get home to my kids. Make sure I can, you know, stay out of jail, because I've been in a situation. I was in a situation, and I was like, yo, if I lie, right, he's going to take me to jail. But if I don't lie, I'm going to make it home tonight.
But the question is, should you have went to jail for actually doing wrong?
Yo, that's, I was not only while going, not only while I would have been in jail, I probably would have had a whole charge. In order to go to jail, you got to catch a charge. You know what I'm saying? So there's been a time, man, where I got pulled over, you know what I'm saying? I had stuff in my car, you know what I'm saying? And police officer was like, yo, you got in the car? I was like, nope.
You know what I mean? But I lied
to him at that time, you feel me? But like I said, I'm trying to get home too at the same time. So, you know, everything come back good. Please let me go home. I made it home, you know. And I know I got to live with that lie, because I know I told that lie. You feel me? But it's like a lie that, you know what I mean, I can live with, because I made it home. You know what I'm saying?
That's where grace comes from, though. That's where God's grace comes from, because he know we got to do it sometimes. that's for real. That's what it's for. That's what the grace is for. It's not in the sense where you want to abuse it, but it's in the sense where it's like your son. You know your son going to lie to you here and there, and you're going to love him regardless. You know what I'm saying?
Because
you understand, like, and that's really what the grace is really all about. It's like, because if I got some shit in the car that I ain't supposed to have, I'm lying to. Like, nah. No, I wasn't smoking that. Like, nah. We smoked it earlier. Like, at the crib, it's just on my clothes. Like,
word, man. I'm out here, man. 2022, man. Coming to the West Indies Festival, man. Noonie Butt, man. She put together this crazy event, man. Got Rick Rogers out here, man.
Yeah,
beautiful
man.
Family, man.
Shout
I love you guys.
Wife,
I love bro. I love both of y'all, man, because y'all both go hard, man. And y'all don't stop, man.
I admire
and y'all
her
keep
for
coming,
this.
You know what I'm saying?
I
y'all
admire keep coming. My wife
nah,
for
you
this.
Go hard too, bro.
This, but this, yeah. Putting together something like this is something that I don't have the confidence to do. That's why I admire her for doing
loud
it.
Facts.
And
loud
it
facts.
Came together nice.
Yeah. And all it takes is somebody right next to you to accomplish. Shit, you know what I'm saying? You're like, oh yeah, we about to do this bigger. Yep, we about to do this again. Yeah, yeah.
At the Coach VA Festival. Like, yeah, let my wife throw that jump.
Loud facts.
Real talk.
Man, it was dope having you today, man. Dope having you. Dope getting to build with you, man. Getting to build with you in a long time, man. And all the people know, man, I got a lot of love from Rick Rogers ever since I've been here, man. So he's one of the dopest artists in the world, man. And he's very inspiring. And just to see him catch this encounter with, you know, Christ and seeing his positive energy switch over is just amazing, man. And it's, I know it's making you feel so much better. I know it has to be.
I just
you know
want to
saying?
Help people, bro. And I never knew how.
Man,
I never
knew
how.
Like the best thing I can do when I'm helping people is to give them the correct information. Information is so valuable. Give them the gems. Give them the things that's worth more than money. Because a lot of people just want the money, but give them something that's worth more than money, man. Give something that they can really you can accomplish something with. You don't take and use and utilize and give it to the next person. You know what I'm saying? Because when you're doing that, that's everything. That's everything, man. Helping a person out, man. And just by smiling at a person or seeing how they doing.
Then everybody need a hug, bro.
Yeah. Sometimes people need a hug.
That's
you know
really
saying?
All it be for real. Yeah. All of us, we need one. Like,
word.
Just a hug. That's it. A word. Real nice, genuine one. Like, and it's going to be okay. Because everybody, I'm trying to tell you, they going through stuff, bro.
Word.
We going through stuff. So it's like, that's why I'm not with antagonizing people. Because we already going through enough on our own. You don't need a whole society making you feel more bad about how you already feel, bro. That's why it's important to be positive,
bro. The society's gonna do that to us, though, because they know it's how they win. As long as they winning and we losing, they have it.
It's a mask anyway.
Yeah.
It's a mask anyway. That's what I don't. That's one of the things I don't like, and one of the things I want to change. Like, I feel like everybody's like a big masquerade party. You know what I'm saying? Because nobody's willing to say how they really feel about anything, like, because they scared to. So I understand that, junk, but I just need people to understand, bro. Like, just be honest, be genuine, bro, so you can change somebody else's life, too. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, change yours and change somebody else's.
Yeah, your story will help the next person's.
Always.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, definitely, man. We got to keep pushing. We got to keep pushing this positive message, man. This positive energy. You know what I'm saying? Christ. You know what I'm saying? We got to keep pushing. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, I'm finna get on the block like a real disciple, bro. With a karaoke. Uh-huh. We bought the karaoke jump. The rap. I'm gonna rap the music. My man gonna preach the word, and we really finna get out here and do it.
Let's go.
It's the only thing I really want people to do is actually open the Bible and read it. Not because I want you to believe in whatever I believe in. I want you to read something that's actually truthful, something that actually can benefit you in your relationships.
Let me ask you a question right quick, right? Knowing that, you know, I'm 40, how old is you?
34.
I'm 41, you 34. All right, so we've been on this earth for a couple decades. Every story you've been through, everything you learned between your own experiences, right? Don't you know that some of them experiences, or can't you relate some of them experiences to some of them experiences you learned read through in the Bible?
That's why I tell people to read it.
but we going through the same
That's
stuff.
That's why,
right?
It's called the Living Word. How can a book from so many years ago relate to every day in your life?
Yeah.
That's what's scary about it to me. You know what I'm saying? In a good way. Not scary because.
Yeah. But take the names out. You gonna be like, yo, that was so and so. That was so and so. Like, man, I recognize so and so from the Bible,
bro.
Right?
When people be laughing, when people be like, that's a Jezebel spirit. Like, no, that's Shorty from out the block that just finessed the homie to get robbed. Like, it's the same thing, bro.
The war, bro.
That's why I'm so intrigued by it. Like, and it was kind of shocking when I first read
it. Our stories is all Bibles,
bro.
Man.
When I read it, bro, I instantly found every issue that was wrong with my marriage, bro.
Come on.
And me and her begin to be able to actually fix our relationship, bro.
Come on.
You know what I'm saying? Like, fixing it. We still working on stuff now because, like, no one's ever going to be perfect. Like, it's hard to not get angry and none of that. But once you understand, when you angry and you respond out of anger, you make things worse.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. It's like, energy you
imagine me going
to
my homies up the street. They're never going to say that. They're going to say, man, fuck Shorty, man. There's mad girls out here. You know what I'm saying? Like,
That's the energy. Think about what they saying. Think about how they coming off. Like, you got to be able to peep the energies, man. When you peep the energies, it's like you see past everything that's out here. You see things for what it really is. Because, you know, people can tell you anything. But how many people are going to tell you the truth? You want the truth. You don't want nobody lie to you.
People scared to tell people the truth.
Exactly. So you got to peep the energies, and you got to be able to be like, yo, I know they ain't gonna tell me the truth, but you know what I'm saying? I'm gonna spend most of the time. People bypass the truth. Saying like, yo,
because they don't,
for whatever reason,
they don't want no one to feel convicted. That's my favorite word in the Bible is conviction.
Mm-hmm.
If I was to come tell you something that was true about you and you feel a way about it, you're gonna get mad. But if I told you something that's gonna make you happy, you just, you know what I mean? If I told you a lie, you can feel good. Like, if I feel like I'm overweight, you know what I mean? I got a little, you know what I mean? So someone telling me I'm not big is just trying to please my feelings, because they know telling me that I'm big probably going to hurt my feelings. But I need for you to tell me the truth.
Yeah, tell me the truth, yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And if it hurts me, it's conviction. Then I have to look at what I'm eating, how much I'm eating, and be honest with myself and fix it. If it doesn't feel good when it's said to me, then I need to fix it.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Loud facts. Either that or... You gotta make sure that, you know, no matter what anybody say, it can't affect you. You know what I'm saying?
But if it does, then it's something that you need to fix. Because if I came to you and said, yo, you on your grind,
it might just be your way of thinking. You feel me? Because you might need to fix it for health reasons. You know what I'm saying? That may be your need to fix. You know what I'm saying? But if your need to fix it because they talking about you.
Nah, you're right.
Then now anybody that can say anything about you, now they control you.
Now you're absolutely right about that.
Now they in full control. You know what I'm saying? They know I can say he this. That's going to tear up his whole shit. That's going to make him feel insecure or whatever
right.
it is. You know what I'm saying? It's this energy, man. We have to really have control over it.
Bro, I'll be in the crib thinking especially at events like this. This is what Jesus and them was doing back in the day.
It's
having
the
little
thing,
gatherings
bro.
And all
no,
that.
No
they just ain't had, they probably ain't had no swag, but maybe they had swag back then. You know what I'm saying?
Bro, it ain't nothing that we have that they didn't have. You know what I'm saying? They had it all, man. Maybe they didn't have like computers or, you know what I'm saying, things like that, but they had their own things. You know what I'm saying? They had things that we ain't got.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But to tell you the truth, it's all the same stuff. You know what I'm saying? And it's all about how we utilize it. You know what I'm saying? Just like the music. They had music, we got music. Right? But look how we utilize the music today.
Mm-hmm.
And now look at the world today. You know what I'm saying? And the music is just transferring the energies. Think about it, the frequencies. You know what I'm saying? That's the energies. You know what I'm saying? And as long as you pushing the BS, you pushing the BS. Stop pushing the BS. That's one thing I do like about the Bible and love about the Bible. That, you know what I'm saying? It's kind of here. And it's crazy because people use it for both reasons, right? Some people use it as to come at people. Some other people is using it to, you know what I'm saying, push Christ. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Some people is doing it to
that's one of the things people be saying, too, that push them away from the jump. But I be trying to get them to understand is like, you can teach me everything you know, and I can take it and do the wrong stuff with it.
Facts.
It don't make what you taught me the. It don't make what you taught me the wrong thing. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. It make the person that's using the information the bad person.
Facts, facts. And we got a whole lot of that out here, man. A whole lot of people out there.
Finessing.
Yeah. You know what I mean? And we got to stop that, man. Especially if we want to see our people, you know, live. You know what I mean? Because the thing is, our people are just getting killed too fast. You know what I mean? And we need to stop that because. We need our people. Our people is the most important thing. You know
kids
what I mean?
Be growing up without dads and stuff, but that junk is like my nephew, son. His real dad got shot in the head when he was like one. He gone.
Yeah.
Then the dude that stepped up in jail for life, he gone. So I'm just like, my heart is like huge for my nephew because it's like I couldn't imagine it. You know what I'm saying? Like, and then on top of that, you got a whole other set of people that's actually happy about this. You're not even thinking about little homie. You know what I'm saying? Like, and this is our community on a daily basis, bro.
Yeah,
it be burning me up to hear almost every murder you hear about is someone 22 and under.
Yeah.
Like, that's scary knowing that our kids got to grow up out hearing that, bro.
Yeah, we got to start in the household with that. You know, the household, we got to make sure that, you know, we watch what we listening to, watch what we pushing, you know what I'm saying? Watch what we watching because the kids is catching on real early, you know? And then when you leave your kids and they go to school, now they out there with all the kids, that's you know what I'm saying? So you got to be careful, man. You
I don't
know
even
what I mean?
Listen to the secular music no more. I haven't in a while, like, industry-wise.
Word.
Even when I'm recording it, sometimes I feel wrong because I'm aiding in it now.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
but
yeah.
That's something that me and God working with, like I'm literally asking him to figure out a way to make it work where I don't have to do it to live my life. Like I have to make money for rent and all that. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But as far as like future, any of that music, I don't hear it the same no more because I'm like, yo, you're not saying nothing
good
or
no
beneficial.
Message.
Yeah, it's like, yo, y'all, it's like, it's crazy. Like, bro, in a scary sense, bro, they pretty much thriving off of death.
Yeah, death, jail.
Y'all thriving
death,
off of
jail,
death, bro.
Or,
yeah,
you know what I'm
like,
saying? Just setting yourself back so you don't have more setbacks. When the plan and everybody's goal is to achieve better, you know what
I'm saying? I be wondering if rappers think about that, like, when they laying at home in their mansion, it's like, yo, do you know your last album just
got
a million people hooked on lean? Like,
yeah, they know that. They got to live with that. I believe that a lot of them come in the game not knowing that, but then they realize that. Meek Mill said a couple years ago, he said he got to make a choice. He got to choose a side.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I'm a state what it is, but I got to finish out my contract because I already signed up for that. There's nothing I can do about that. Or else, you know what I mean, they're going to owe me forever. Because once you sign them contracts, you know what I'm saying? You sign. You know what I'm saying? Unless you can get out of that contract, you still sign. And you still got to come up with this, especially if you need to, you know what I mean, have an expensive lifestyle. You got to come up with that money.
Nah, I understand that.
So it can be where, though, you know, he's still in his contract. You know what I mean? He still got to release music. Because a lot of labels, they don't want you. You can't go in there and try and do what you're doing right now. So that's why I'm glad that you're independent. You can do whatever you want. If you want to make a Christian album tomorrow, man, you want to make powerful, positive energy music tomorrow, you could do that. If you were signed to a label that grabbed you off of what you, you know what I'm saying, used to create, what is it, chop
yeah.
Block? Yeah, you know what I'm saying? If you were signed from that time, you know what I'm saying, they going to want that energy from you.
Yeah.
They're not going to want that. They're going to be like, you going to be like, oh, I came with this. They're going to be like, what?
That whole little battle for real is really what be juicing me up to do it. That's why I took the approach I took on the album. Because just from me and me talking to God, he's going to allow me to actually get in the industry with the music I have because I made it in a way that you wouldn't. Only reason you know is about God is because I mentioned his name.
What?
If not, you would still think you're listening to this another saga of Rick Miyaga. So I really feel like I'm finna build a bridge from everyone who want to know and the people who already know. And I feel like
that's
with
dope.
The industry, it's sick to say, but they only sell it because we buy it. So if I make something that's good that they want to buy, they're going to want to do business because they only care about money. You know what I'm saying? So I actually think I have a good chance of getting in there and making this conversation like,
I know
relevant.
You do, man. I know you do. You know what I'm saying? You just got to give it all your energy, man.
And then my boy Marcus Rogers, you know, I've been on his albums for like the last 5-6 years, and he's getting millions and millions of streams. Like, he's real popular. So he really set the stage for me to be able to do this next. In a big way already. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? But I'm not even like focused on reaching the people that already know who God is. I want to reach the people who are questioning them. Like,
right.
Like, my music is, the album is not about like, oh, I'm holy, I'm so like happy. It's like, nah, it's like, I'm my same struggle. It's the same thing, but it's like, I have, it's like when I listen to Rod Wave sometimes, I love him as an artist, but I feel like he's the type of person to walk you down the darkest alley and leave you there. With no way to get out of what you feeling.
Okay.
At least mentioning God, I give you a way to fight it. You know what I'm saying? And I didn't even know that that's what was going on. I'm going to tell you one of the realest stories that I told you when I got into it and I started questioning God. Like, is you real? Is this real? Or am I tripping, right? Mm-hmm. I'm actually in Chicago recording Marcus, like Christian music, and I'm still questioning this. Like, man, I hope I ain't tripping. Like, I don't want to look stupid. One of this girl I know, she texted me because I had posted a clip of a song. And she was like, y'all want you to know that your song saved my life. And I'm like, what you mean? She was like, she was, I guess, like, she tried to kill herself one day, right? Mm-hmm. And her daughter ran to a neighbor. He was a doctor. He kind of brought her back to life or whatever the case may be. But she still won't satisfy, right? So she was finna kill herself again. But she picked up her phone to call her mom, to hear her voice one last time before she died. Before she killed herself, but her phone died. So when she charged her phone, she get on Instagram and my song popped up. And she said she's been fighting with that song every day since that day. So I'm like, how can I, like, why would I question it if me talking about God in the song is helping her stay alive? Yeah,
definitely.
That's how I made my decision. I want to do that. That's better than any amount of streams I could ever get.
Facts, man. The confirmation is everything, man. And that's what I always love doing this, man. Because, yo, this peeping the confirmation is like, yeah. I know I'm doing the right thing. Like, you know what I mean? I ain't got to even think about this no more. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
It's so many confirmations out there. You know what I mean? Just keep them coming, baby. I'm running.
And you know what's crazy? Me and my wife, because I don't know where she was at with Christ. Like, that's what I understand with that is that's not my business.
Uh-huh.
We talk about it. We more along the same line now. But when I was talking to her about what it feels like, she was like, it feels like if you have a stampede of people walking one way, when you start walking with Christ, you're the person that got to turn around and walk the other way. Understanding when you do that, you're bumping everybody. So it always feels uncomfortable and odd when you're trying to do the right thing. But that's how you know you're doing the right thing.
Yeah.
When you have to hit them bumps, like, because you're going against the grain.
All the time.
Yeah.
All the time. Man, this is dope, man. This is dope being able to build out here in the park at this event. And like,
yeah,
this is dope, man. Like, I didn't even know we was gonna do this today, man. But this is dope, man. And then the conversation it was even doper because the conversation was so real. You know what I mean? Yeah, man. God
I'm
is
so
dope,
ready,
man. For all the people that don't know, man. And you are dope too, man. So please, man, make the connection work, man. It's a connection with you and what you got and who you trust, man.
I know you want the album early too.
Yeah, you know I always want the album early, man. I always want that. Yo, man, I love your music. You already know that, man. Yo, I drove around this whole state, man, for a long time, man, and I was just asking people, man, who is the artist out here? Who is the engineer out here? Who you know what I'm saying? Who is nice out here, man? And I would hear
Powered by Regeus.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I definitely on this album, being that it is different. Like, I've been sending it to all the people that I cherish, like, as people and as opinion, you know what I'm saying? I've been getting good feedback and I've been getting mixed feedback.
Okay.
But I understand where the mixed feedback come from, because I no longer carry a victim mentality, because I'm aware of what I've done in my life that made things the way they were.
Fact.
I blame everybody for everything that ever happened to me. I've never once said what I've done wrong to somebody, bro.
that's
unfair.
It all starts with who?
Me.
Yeah.
That's so unfair. Like, I was talking to my man, just like, he was trying to figure out why I'm doing what I'm doing. I'm like, yo, like, I have a mad people that look up to me for the wrong reasons, because I've been lying.
Come on.
Not in the sense that I'm faking about what's going on, but I'm not being real. Like, I told half of the story. So with these new albums that's finna come out, I just want to completed.
You taking them through the alley and leaving them there.
Yes.
Now you gotta take it through the alley.
My man was like, man, but people love your music. People relate. I'm like, everyone relates to being a victim. Nobody relates to accountability.
Right.
You feel me?
Right.
So that's the issue.
That's what we need, man. So I'm glad you're gonna make some music that's gonna really hold yourself accountable, to show other people to hold themselves accountable. You know what I'm saying? Because we gotta all hold ourselves accountable for our own actions all the time, man. And if you really don't want to live with a lie, you know what I'm saying, then don't lie. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But if you gotta live with it. You know what I'm saying?
But if you get caught by the police and you gotta
live with it, you know what I'm saying? Because listen, do not tell on yourself. I'm telling you right now. I'm telling you right now. They will take you to jail. They will not care about you told them the truth or none of that.
And so I had a cop lie on me in court.
Yeah, and they lie all the time. So I'd rather, you know, not make the lie to, you know, Rick Rise is my girl, you know what I mean? People that I really, you know what I'm saying?
But if you do the right thing, you don't even have to lie.
Yeah, true indeed. But sometimes, you know, in these times, you know what I mean, a lot of us come from a time, right, where all we did was the wrong thing. You know, and like me, that's all I used to do was the wrong thing. So years ago when a cop pulled me over, you know what I'm saying? I was definitely doing the wrong thing. You know what I mean?
You knew at the time what you was doing was wrong?
Yeah, you always know what you doing is wrong.
See, that's a conversation you know for another day on another platform. Because when it comes to us and our community, people don't be feeling where I'm coming from with that. I know what I've been doing wrong since I was at least 5 years old. You know moment. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So
you might not know, you know, how God works and how energy works, but you might know you did the wrong thing. You might not know, like, some people right now today, you know, they might do a lot of the wrong things, right? But they don't even know, like, yo, all they really got to do is stop if they really want to make things happen. Like, they all got to do is change that up and do the right thing. You know what I'm saying? Like, I didn't know that, yo, all I had to do was change it up and do the right thing the right way. You know what I'm saying? I thought I would just, you know what I mean, not supposed to sell.
Was that a decision for you? Like a moment in the crib or something? And you were just like, man, you know what? I'm about to just stop effing around and.
Oh yeah, that was a decision. That was a decision here in Virginia. Because when I got here, you know, I was still like gambling and stuff. I was still making trips. You know what I'm saying? Back to the casino when I got here. You know, and at one point, you know, it came to a point where it was like, everything got to stop. But I need help at this point. You know what I'm saying? Because I keep going back. I've been going back you know what I'm saying, since I was a kid. You know what I mean? So it came to a point where it was like, all right, well, at this point right now, I'm in so much pain, right? Because, you know, the relationship was going on. Me and my shorty at the time, we had broke up. And then the casino was tearing me apart. And I felt like I was slipping back into who I was before I moved here. Going back into, you know, a bum lifestyle where, you know, today I got it all. Tomorrow I'm broke as hell. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And at that point, I said, yo, I can't do it no more. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I was thinking, like, yo, the only way I ever really win is when I got that positive energy. So I had to figure out a way to keep that positive energy at all times.
And the wins feel better when you did it the right way.
Yeah, always. So my thing was, you know, I wanted to teach people how powerful they was. Because I knew how powerful I was. I knew I was powerful. I knew I was, like, ain't nothing I can't go out there and create. Like, it don't matter what it is. Like, if I say I'm going to go create it, I'm going to go create it. So I was like, the thing is, we got to show people how powerful it is. We got to teach them that it's energy. They don't understand that they got to control their own energy. And once we can get them to gain control, because think about it, right? All the masses control us through the music, through the media, through the internet. They control how we think, how we feel, how we react. We don't have self-control, a lot of us. So that's why the jails is filled. That's why so many people have no communicational skills. They're not able to communicate with other people. You know what I mean? So it's like, yo, if we can go out here and teach people how powerful they is, we can really, you know what I'm saying, make a dent in the system. Because the system is to keep us dumb, to keep us down, keep us not knowing, keep us signing these contracts that we don't know what we signing to. And then we find out that they raping us. You know what I'm saying? So it's like, nah, we got to go teach certain people something different. And then I was like, all right, well, now I'm going to have to make a deal with God. Like, remember, I'm not a religious person. I ain't no spirit. I ain't no Christian.
But you know.
But I know there's a power higher than me that I trust in. I trust in. I love it. And it's like, all right, well, boom. This is what I'm going to do. I'm going to start working for you. I ain't going to work for the devil no more. I done gave the devil enough time, and all I keep feeling is pain. And now I'm going to give, you know, God all the glory. I'm going to run for God. I'm a runner. I'm going to run hard for God, right? And I said, all right, well, how I'm going to do it? And that's how I came up with the 757 Rap Music Awards. I said, since I ain't got no bread, you know what I mean? I ain't got no big money to go out there and do things like Jay-Z do if he came here today, everybody follow Jay-Z. Said, but I got grind, you feel me? I got hustle, I got ambition. Go out here and push positive energy. And then boom, you know, I started promoting the awards, building the momentum for the awards and stuff, right? And then they shut down on us, right? But at the beginning, I was telling everybody, this ain't me, this God. I was like, yo, this God, y'all think this is me, but this ain't me, this God. Just keep watching, you know what I'm saying? Keep watching, you know what I'm saying? I'm working for the Most High. That's how I know it's God, because right. I'm already working for the Most High, you know what I'm saying? So, and the whole time, I'm telling everybody, you know what I'm saying, with the Facebook and everything. I'm telling everybody, but I'm showing people that you know, it's all in you, the power's in you. You got the ability to do this, you know what I'm saying? And boom, man. COVID came, the whole thing down. By that time, man, you was rapping, we was talking, you know, and we started the podcast network, you know, the podcast studio. And for that year, ain't nobody come through and holler at us. It wasn't like no podcast that signed up or nothing like that. But I kept telling people, this guy, like, you know, keep watching, you know what I'm saying? And now look at us now, you know what I mean? We 3 years in, radio stations everywhere now. I'm ready to do the awards, you know what I'm saying? I'm ready to put together the awards. Yeah, I'm ready to do the promo. What's the summer camp program is over, because we got a summer camp program right now at the Boys and Girls Club. Once that ends at the end of August, I'm ready to go into the promotion for the 757 Rap Music Awards, and I'm ready to put that together, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And keep things going, keep things building, keep the momentum going, man. I really want to get you down in the studio with us, man. I know you work with a lot of people, man. And I really want to get you doing some work with us, too,
believe
man.
Believe it or not, I don't, bro. I cut it all off.
Yeah.
Not because of Christ, just because I was doing too much.
Okay.
So what I did was I just found a few artists that can give me the same money 30, 60, 40 people would give me. You know what
right,
I'm saying?
Right, right.
So I just work with I really only record two people right now at this moment.
Word.
In a session here or there. But right now, I just really work with two people that's real heavy. And I got tired of working with people who only make music just to make music.
Word.
Like, they don't make t-shirts, they don't drop albums, they don't put money in promotion, they don't do any of that. So it's like, I don't want to waste my time for no bread, you know what I'm
right,
saying?
Right, right. Definitely, man. Man, I really want you to come down and do some work with us too, man, man. Please, man, because I love all the work that you do, man. Like, no matter if it's the music, no matter if it's the video, I always call you a musical genius, man. And you are, man. And I love pushing what you got or what you create. And I believe what you can create can help people relate. All it is building a relationship. These people got a relationship with Rod Wave and all these other artists. And I believe that people will have a relationship with you. I went all the way to North Carolina and I was driving all around VA with Chili, you know what I'm saying? And people was relating to you and listening to you, you know what I'm saying? And they was loving you. So I already knew that was going to happen. So yeah, man, I hope we can come together to do some things, work on the next event together, recover the media the best way possible. Really work together, man, because, you know what I mean, we all believe in God. We all know that, you know, what we got to do to fix things. Once we believe in ourselves, we can start to believe in each other.
Yeah.
And I believe in you from day one. From day one, I believe in you, and I believe you believe in me. And I believe that if we build together, man, it's going to be awesome, bro. You know what I mean? Perfect timing, man. You are a goat out here, man. You are a goat in the world, man. And I just seen when you was tagging me in the producer thing that you had going on with all the producers. That was a dope experience. Where'd you go for that? Where was that? What state was that in?
What you mean?
You had like a Facebook and group, and it was like a video in there, and you was producing with all these different producers.
That was G White did that. G White did that. I was supposed to be there. But
one of them joints you was there. That's the last one.
Oh, that probably was. I know I be going to writing camp sometimes. That's what it was. I went to a writing camp in LA one time, and then I went to another one in Atlanta.
So you been to a writing camp in LA and another one in Atlanta.
Mm-hmm.
Music take you far, bro.
Yeah, my music done took me everywhere, bro. I ain't had to pay a dime.
Like the
bro.
Army takes some people around
bro,
the world.
I've been traveling for free for like 10 years, bro.
Music take you around the world. Wow, man, that's dope, man. So don't stop, man. Don't stop, man.
I ain't never paid for a hotel. I ain't never paid for a rental. I don't pay for food when I'm out of town. I don't pay for anything, man.
You've been blessed, man. Some people have been rapping 20 years. Ain't never been nowhere out of their project.
Yeah.
So you've been blessed, man, to come across great people, man. Just continue to pass the blessings, man. Pass the blessings, man. And keep doing what your heart tell you to do, man. Especially if you feel it in your heart, you know it's right. Keep doing it, man.
So
keep
we have
it.
A Christian type festival. You coming out here?
Oh yeah, man. Listen, man. Loud does not discriminate. Doesn't matter what you do, man. As long as you're not pushing negativity, to me, it don't matter what you're doing. I love all people. They ain't got to do that. And like, there's another way to.
I do that a whole lot when I see these Yeah. Especially when I see these young, like a lot of times young boys still hit me up about studio time. And when I go to their page and I see guns and all that, bro, I just be, even before I ran into God, I'm like, bro, I be letting them know you don't have to do it. You know what I'm saying? Like from me to you, bro, like you don't have to do what your friend's telling you to do.
Right, right.
You know what I'm saying? Like do something different, bro, because
yeah,
I just don't want to see it.
Shout
I don't want
to
see
for
the
that, man. You definitely got to keep your word into them, man. Keep speaking the word into them because, like you said, even if back then you wasn't like on your Christian time, wasn't really pushing what you pushing now, but you was pushing them to stop promoting BS.
Yeah,
if you really want to be a shooter, then join the army. They take care of their shooters.
No,
they,
if you want to be a shooter, join God and shoot the devil.
Yeah,
do that.
But let's say you want to play with the guns and you want to, you know what I'm saying? Your thing is guns, like. There's the army, there's the navy, there's, you know what I'm saying? All
right. It's like a time and a place for whatever you're trying to do.
Yeah. You can play with guns all the time. Like you can practice with the guns and have gun fun. You know what I'm saying? And you can also collect benefits, get paychecks, go to school for free. You know, travel for free.
Yeah.
Instead of being a shoot out here in the hood and
let it
being on a run
you,
forever.
What you're saying. Let it benefit you if you're gonna do it.
Yeah, if you're gonna do it right, man. Do it right, man. There's a right way and a wrong way, man. And the wrong way is to keep our people down, man. You feel me? Yeah, man, it's getting dark out here. This was dope out here. We lit out here. You already know 2022 coming to the West Indies Festival. Crazy.
It's definitely going to be back next year, too.
Oh, yeah, every year. This is going to be an annual thing, man. We got to keep this thing going, man. This is dope. What time you got?
No, 8:30.
We still got 30 minutes, man.
Yep,
shout out to Easy, man.
Hey,
yo, thank you, Rick, man. I got to give you a hug,
bro.
My brother. Hold on, man. Now, facts, man. I got to get up.
Already, bro. No.
So to start off, my brother. Word up, man. Word up, man. We see this thing going, bro. Feel me?
You know what I mean? Hey, anybody out there listening, man, look. You know if you're doing something wrong, man, just stop doing that junk, man. Stop doing the wrong thing. Start doing the right thing so the right things should come into your life. Because the more you do wrong, the more wrong you just going to bring into your life. And it's just going to keep getting worse and worse. No matter how much better you think it's getting worse. So just stop it today and turn it around and just do the right thing from here on out, man.
Loud facts, man. Coming to the West Indies 2022, man. That was Rick Rogers, the GOAT, man. Rick Rogers, man. Ricky Miyagi for Christ on the way.
On the way.
Man, let's tap back in, man. This is Easy right here, man. Heavy artillery music. Let's go.